1, 2, 1, 2. Good morning, Dodos.
Good morning.
Yeah, glad to see you all here, and let's start our weekly meeting with a new video.
После того, как я закончил университет, я удачно женился и некоторое время не работал. Меня обеспечила жена. Все же я потом пошел на работу. Я начал заниматься ремонтом квартир. Вот, и мне это очень нравилось. Но потом я вспомнил о том, что у меня есть диплом инженера, ну и решил попробовать себя в этом. Когда я увидел на Авито вакансию проектировщик в компанию Dodo Pizza, я подумал, что это прикол какой-то. В итоге меня пригласили на собеседование, ну и я сижу, думаю такой, ну надо чем-то удивлять. Вот, а чем может удивлять парень, который вырос в деревне? Вот, ну и я решил удивлять честностью. Сказал, что у меня есть только мой диплом и огромное желание работать и отдавать всего себя. Мне нравится что-то создавать, делать своими руками. Вот, и одно из хобби, которое у меня есть, я создавал, я даже не знаю как, игрушки, это можно назвать, наверное, из кинокомиксов Marvel. Вот молот Тора, может кто-то видел в нашем офисе, щит Капитана Америки. Я посещаю спортзал, но это сейчас носит ну, такой поддерживающий характер. В 19 лет я весил всего лишь 70 килограмм. Я да, действительно пошел в зал для того, чтобы набрать мышечную массу. Вот, у меня это получилось, сейчас я вешу 90. Но больше всего меня вдохновляют люди, которые не сидят на месте, находятся в постоянном движении. Будь то классный руководитель, или хороший бизнесмен, или просто там хороший муж, да, или замечательный отец для своих детей. В общем, люди, которые идут вперед, работают над собой и меняют мир вокруг себя, вот, в чем бы то ни было, вот эти люди меня очень сильно вдохновляют.
Okay, guys, before my presentation, I would like, just well, traditionally maybe, to welcome our newcomers. So they are Andrei Kozlov. Well, Andrei Kozlov is our new IT developer, so welcome on board, Andrei. So Dmitry Park is going to become, is going to join our business developers family. Welcome. And Mikhail Drozdov, he's our new designer, okay. Good morning once again. My name is Renat, and my mission at the company is developing international markets. You know, some of you may be wondering, like, Renat, what the hell are you doing, and how does that add you to the whole company and to our international franchisees? Well, from a long priority, I think business, international business developers can bring the main value in creating a system that will let us manage and scale our international business. And now, let's take a look on some projects we were implementing for the last couple of months. So here they are. Recruiting new franchisees, running new countries, and some operational projects in marketing, product, and country developing. You know, when I saw these projects for the first time from above, I thought like, bingo, that's it. That's already kind of system when you need to find new people to work with, you need to help them to open their pizza stores in their countries, and then you need to support them with some operational and marketing instruments. And you know, if we review all my current activities for the last 3 or 4 months, we can recognize that, well, I have executed more in recruitment of new franchisees and running new countries rather than in operational projects. And perhaps this is not a surprise because we have a steady and, well, what is more important, sometimes unexpectedly demand for our franchise among international audience. And by the way, this is just without a bunch of marketing activities campaign. Isn't that cool, right? But that demand shouldn't mislead you because we still have to process this bunch of requests. Well, and at the beginning, it was a kind of challenge for us because we got and we still get this requests from different channels like LinkedIn, Facebook, Gmail, Dodo Pizza Story, website, etc. And from another side, most of these requests came from came to different people who collected and managed information by their own. And of course, it was a little bit messy in this process. And when we got this challenge, we started to think how we can maintain a constant stream of recruiting new franchisees without losing important details about them. And I would like to highlight this question because this not only a question, this is at the same time that's going to be our main result if we can achieve an unstoppable process in this process. Okay, we got this problem and we started to think what we can do with that. And we made very simple but at the same time logic system of three steps. Step number one, Maxim Kodin has become to be responsible for all international franchise requests, whether they come from Russia or from other international markets. As Maxim has already promoted our brand in the United States, we thought that that's going to be the best decision to take care of all this stuff. Well, he holds the initial interview with the potential franchisee and gives his tentative overview. He also has some special instruments like Trello board where he can record all necessary information about each request. Okay, step number two. If Maxim, according to Maxim's comments, we need to decide whether we're ready or not to invite a potential franchisee to our Moscow headquarters for further negotiations. And if the answer is yes, he comes to Russia to meet our real Moscow pizza stores, meet our team, meet our office, learn some more information about our Dodo IS system. And of course, the main purpose is to meet with us, just, to see at each other and so on and so on. Well, step number three, finally, if we approve a potential franchisee, we start to prepare some necessary papers such as this informative presentation, like it was with Nigeria. With our vision of running Dodo Pizzas in a new country and with some important details of the future partnership. And of course, we can discuss some points from this presentation just to make sure that everything is clear for both sides. Well, furthermore, in addition to this document, we can also assist a new partner with many other things. For example, preparing financial model, help with finding investors, make a tentative visualization of future stores, etc. And this is exactly how we meet our current franchisees. For example, this is exactly how we met Thomas and Michael Thomas from Una Pizza, who are going to become our master franchisee in Germany. And also, this is how we met these smart guys from Nigeria, who are very prospective for us in this region. All right, we've got a new partner. What is next? It's not a secret, running a country is a very complex project, but the main challenge among all the rest is the time of opening. Just imagine, we had been launching Brighton store for 13 months, which outstandingly bad result to my mind. So in other words, we had to answer the question, how can we speed up our project execution to reduce overall time of running a country? And we did some retrospective study of the last country openings and we got some insights, I think very important insights that we can implement at the beginning of the project. And here they are, market research and Dodo.is country modifications. As for the first point, traditionally collecting information about a new market is the very first step at the beginning of the project. And of course, recently we spent a lot of time and resources on it because you need to get an overview about a new country, suppliers, customers, restrictions in legislation, regulations, etc. Then you have to provide this bunch of information with other teams like marketing, Dodo.is, etc. and so on. And it took a lot of time because business developer recently did his job by his own. Okay, next. Finally, we got this situation when a new franchisee simply didn't have a full overview about his market or about his country, and he just missed some important details. And of course, after getting this insight, we made a decision to always ask a new franchisee to do this job by himself. And we also helped him with it by sharing this special checklist, like Dodo S checklist, market analysis checklist, or ingredients checklist. So in these documents, we can find all necessary information to make a future decision about ingredients, products, future menu. In these documents, we can find some details to help our IT guys to deploy Dodo.js in a new country. And of course, we can find some marketing insights from current competitors and so on. Well, after we have started to implement such approach, even in Slovenia, so we got several very important values. So the first one is our potential, our new franchisees will be more involved in the process of running a store. And what is more important, they will be more informed about some details that can help them to be successful in their markets. And we will get more expertise as well in this case, by the way. So secondly, a franchisee has an ability to start to collect market insights much in advance before we can open a country. For example, if we are going to run a country in 6 months, well, a new franchisee can start market research right now. Okay, as for Dodo.js modifications, besides Dodo.js checklists, of course, well, overall approach of doing IT tasks was changed. So just imagine opening Brighton, while opening Brighton store, we implemented all IT issues one by one. And that was absolutely ineffective from a speed point. So we suggested, what if we take a bunch of all IT tasks and try to do it at the same time or in a short period of time, involving in this process most of IT teams. And we assumed that 2 or 3 months was enough to finish all IT issues and to deploy a working system in a new country. And you know what? Surprise, surprise. Our theory was confirmed because the next country where we launched our brand was Belarus. And it took us only 2.5 months to run the very first pizza store in this country. So now we're running Slovenia and it is also supposed to be opened in 2.5 months. So I'm sure that's maybe not a great result, but it's a good result because we reduced the time of opening just 6 times less. So now, ladies and gentlemen, stay tuned for updates about our international developing. And well, I would like to thank you for this pleasure of speaking to you. Now we have Ilya Litovaltsev with his story about technical support.